with Guy Pearce and Joe Alwyn, the two stars of FS's A Christmas Carol, with Christmas almost a week away. They're bringing us a fresh new take on the classic holiday tale. Gentlemen, welcome. Guy, good to see you. Hey, good to see you, Joe. A Christmas Carol is timeless, okay? But there have been dozens of adaptations, but no one has quite done it like you guys have done it. So in a few words, what can you tell us about the movie?
Well, I think with Steve Knight, our writer, he's just taken us to a slightly darker place than perhaps other versions might have gone to before.
Darker?
Yeah, to say the least. A little more confronting, perhaps.
Yeah, and you know, you play Scrooge.
I do.
Which is an iconic...
I don't know why I was cast as Scrooge.
But how did you go about reinventing Scrooge, such an iconic character?
Well, I really relied on Nick Murphy, our director, and Steve, our writer. I mean, they talked about playing Scrooge as sort of a younger man, someone more robust, someone who was in the sort of prime of his life and really prepared to take on life, not such a sort of wizened up, scared old man who was, you know, running away from everything. So really, it was their perspective on it that I just took on board.
And then, Joe, we're going to look at a clip. But in this clip, your character's trying to get home a little earlier to celebrate Christmas, so cool. Let's check it out.
I'm not accustomed to talking about these matters with you. I ask you again, is everything all right with you?
Christmas, it seems, inspires such emotion, good and evidently bad.
And there you good and bad. And there you're Bob, you play Bob Cratchit.
I do.
And so I'm curious for you. You even said to yourself, it's hard to feel the shoes that were worn by Kermit.
I've actually never seen Kermit either.
You never, but you did you ever see the version with Kermit?
My main competition's a frog. No, I should, but I haven't yet.
Yeah.
Building up to it.
He's too nervous to take it on.
You're too nervous to take it on. Is it hard for you both when you have a film like this, you know it's in the memory of everybody who's ever watched this movie for Christmas, which is a tradition. Is it overwhelming at times? Or do you think, I got to get it just right?
It is to a degree, but because we have these great scripts in front of us and we know that they're different to other versions before, we're really relying on that. And once you're in the process of actually making it, then yes, you do sort of tend to forget about the others. It's not until now that you're sitting here and we're reminded of the other versions that we go, oh, that's right, hopefully we did something innovative. So, you know, I think we're okay though.
And Christmas is in full swing. How are you two going to celebrate?
Well, I'll probably be nicer to you than Scrooge would normally say to Bob Cratchit.
He wasn't on set, though.
No, I wasn't very nice. Well, I'll be back in Amsterdam with my little boy and teaching him about making snowballs and Christmas trees and things like that, but probably pretty low-key.
Now, if you weren't nice, they think you're nice now. You heard that. And Joe, how about you?
I'll be in London with family, doing various Christmas traditions and, you know, drinking too much.
Eating too much Christmas pudding.
Yeah, just like a lot of us will be doing. Hey, Merry Christmas to both of you. Thank you so much for bringing us A Christmas Carol. Make sure you check it out. It premieres Thursday on FX.